This is the 2019 Pleasureway Ascent, and it's arguably the best 19-foot class BRV built on the Sprinter chassis. And I say that because Pleasureway has been perfecting the Ascent with incremental improvements since 2007, and they've now gotten it to the point where it pretty much is, in my book, the best 19-foot camper van that you can buy. Now, full disclosure, I own a 2017 Ascent, and you can say that makes me biased, or you could say that I know what I'm talking about. In any case, it's not surprising that last year Airstream came out with their Interstate 19, which is a shorter version of their very popular Interstate EXT models, those models being built on the 170-inch Sprinter chassis and clocking in at over 24 feet in length. It makes a lot of sense for Airstream to have introduced their Interstate 19 model, since many of its buyers are loyal Airstream owners downsizing from larger trailers and are looking for something like the Ascent, but with the Airstream brand. So they introduced the Interstate 19 last year, and there's an awful lot that's very similar to the Ascent. Starting with some of the basics, both are built on the excellent Mercedes Sprinter 2500 chassis. That chassis has the exact same engine found on the larger 3500 Sprinter chassis. It's a 3-liter V6 diesel engine capable of delivering 188 horsepower and 325 pound-feet of torque. They both have the exact same exterior dimensions, 19.5 feet in length, 6 feet 7 inches in width, 9 feet 7 inches in height. The Ascent does have an interior standing height 1 inch taller at 6 feet 3 inches, the Interstate 19 6 foot 2 inches. As far as exterior detailing, you could easily confuse these two with one another. The Ascent has larger fiberglass running boards on the bottom, but on the driver's side, the Interstate 19 is a bit cleaner looking with no vents for the refrigerator and just a single small vent for the Truma Combi hot water and coach heating system. As well, both coaches have an almost identical layout with your lounge slash bed in the back, your galley midsection along the passenger side, and your bathroom on the driver's side. Your tank sizes are also nearly identical, with 20 gallons of fresh water and 15 gallons of gray water. The Ascent has a larger 12-gallon black water tank compared to the Interstate 19's 10 gallons. The Interstate 19 has a larger LP tank at 9.34 gallons compared to the Ascent's 8.16 gallons. So, very similar tank sizes all around, with neither coach having an advantage over the other in terms of your boondocking times, at least as it relates to your tank sizes. So from the outside and even on the inside, these coaches seem very similar, but there are some important differences. Let's start with the beds. On the Interstate 19, the bed is 66 inches by 73, and it's pretty cool. The ottomans electrically jackknife into position, making it easier to set up and tear down the bed. On the Ascent, the bed is 70 by 72 inches, so it's 4 inches wider and 1 inch shorter. And importantly, you have to manually fill in the center section. But the Ascent uses thicker memory foam on its sofa and ottomans, and without the metal framing needed for the jackknifing system, the bed is just more comfortable to sleep on. That's my opinion. I'm not saying the bed is uncomfortable on the Interstate 19, just that it's more comfortable on the Ascent. So you'll need to check each one out yourself to determine bed comfort and see how important the bed setup is to you. In lounge mode, the Interstate 19 has some advantages over the Ascent. It has armrests and cup holders, none of which are available on the Ascent. And for that added cool factor, the rear and side blinds electrically raise and lower. But, and this is an important difference, the Ascent has two additional three-point seat belts in the lounge. The Interstate 19 only has lap belts, and this makes the Ascent much more safe for carrying passengers. And in addition, the Ascent comes with a standard inflatable bed system for the front seats, which means that it can safely carry 4 passengers and sleep 3. The Interstate 19 can only safely carry 2 passengers and sleep 2. So you have to decide which is more important to you, lounge comfort for 2 or passenger safety for 4. Heading into the galley, the Ascent has a larger and deeper sink and taller high-neck faucet, which makes it easier to wash dishes. Both coaches have the same 2-burner propane stove. Both also have countertop extensions, but on the Interstate 19, it slides out over the ottoman. On the Ascent, it flips up on the other end of the galley, which is smart because it can also be used as a workstation for the passenger seat when you have that seat swiveled around. The Ascent has more storage under and above the counter. The Interstate 19, though, has a small pantry. The Interstate 19 features a smaller 3.2 cubic foot compressor-driven refrigerator with a larger freezer. The Ascent has a larger automatic switching 3.8 cubic foot three-way refrigerator with a smaller freezer. So, do you want more freezer or refrigerator space? And while we're talking about power-hungry appliances like refrigerators, let's talk about the electrical systems on these coaches. The Ascent has a superior electrical system with a 2,000 watt inverter and 200 amp hours of lithium batteries, standard. The Interstate 19 has a 1,000 watt inverter and 2 6-volt lead acid batteries. But it also comes with 250 watts of solar standard, while on the Ascent, 200 watts of solar is a $1,500 option. Still, in my book, the Interstate 19 needs to up its power game with at least a 2,000 watt inverter and an option to upgrade to lithium, especially with that power-hungry compressor-driven refrigerator. Let's compare the bathrooms. They're both three-piece wet baths, which means that the shower, toilet, and sink all share the same space. They're both pretty small, but when you have these small bathrooms, every inch counts, and the Interstate 19 angles the toilet and flares out the wall towards the front of the van to give you more knee room when seated on the toilet and just a bit more elbow room when standing. The Interstate 19 features a window on the door to let a bit more light in. On the Ascent, there's an opening window to the outside, which helps with ventilation. The aisleway in the Ascent is also about 3 inches wider since the bathroom doesn't push out into it. So you'll need to decide which is more important to you, a more spacious bathroom or more maneuverability room inside the coach. All right, let's talk about price, options, and warranty. Both coaches are premium coaches, at least from a cost standpoint. The Interstate 19 can be found with dealer pricing around $153,000. The Ascent can be found with dealer pricing around $148,000. But keep in mind, the Interstate 19 comes with some standard features that are optional on the Ascent, like its side and rear screen doors and 250 watts of solar. And the Interstate 19 has some features which aren't available on the Ascent, like a side view camera system, an air suspension, and most importantly, an all-wheel drive option. The Ascent, on the other hand, is built to a higher quality standard and comes with a 5-year coach warranty compared to the Interstate 19's 3-year coach warranty. Now, 3 years isn't so bad, but at this price, I would expect them to match Pleasureway's 5-year warranty. And with regards to Pleasureway being higher quality, all I can say is that the Ascent is built in a stall while the Interstate 19 is built on an assembly line. Assembly lines are optimized for mass production. Stalls are a much slower build process, taking Pleasureway up to 6 weeks to build a single coach. Now, for the record, I'm not saying that the Interstate 19 is poor quality. It's not. I am saying that the Pleasureway Ascent is higher quality. So, if you're someone who loves the Airstream brand, or if you just really need all-wheel drive, then the Interstate 19 is the right choice for you. If, on the other hand, quality backed by a longer warranty is more important, or you want to carry 4 passengers in 3-point seatbelts and sleep 3, then the Ascent is the right choice for you. Okay, that wraps it up. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you all next time. Take care. Bye-bye.